I'm a full service shop. Not only do I repair and restore instruments, I also buy, sell, and consign. My name is Gabriel De Hoyos. I own Gabriel Guitar Repair and Consignment in Dallas, Texas. I think my specialty is fretwork. When people ask, hey, Gabe, can you do a fret job? That's a bit of a loaded question. I usually go back and ask them, what type of instrument? What's your playing style? What are you looking for? From experience and seeing different instruments that maybe are just fine and they're worn out and they just need new frets, to guitars that, hey, this board is completely shot. We got to take that board out. We got to make a brand new fingerboard, pop it on, and then plane it out and do the fretwork correctly. I don't only close cracks and do fretwork. I work on a lot of electric guitars. I mean, shredder guitars as well. You know, those Floyd Roses. I mean, those do come in and I respect them equally as well as a $15,000 classical guitar. I mean, it's important to my clients, important to me. I do a lot of pickup swaps, a lot of modifications, all the way up to building sides for guitars. I had a 1943 Ramirez that came in. A shipping company had destroyed the guitar between Germany and Dallas. And I had to go in that instrument and order Spanish Cypress from Spain and plane it down and shape it and actually literally build a patch to the guitar. I do French polishing, like shellacking guitars. I like to work with old school tools, you know, hand planes and chisels and rasp and scrapers. There's a tactile sensation that you have when you're able to run a really sharp blade through a piece of hardwood. I don't only work on guitars. I work on zithers, I think that's a term for it, which is a stringed instrument. I see mariachi instruments, bajo sextos, guitarrons, guitarras de farro, which is a Portuguese type instrument. I do modifications a lot. Hey, my neck is not comfortable. Could you reshape my guitar neck? That's a pretty serious thing. I mean, we're removing wood and there's no going back. So when I shape a client's guitar neck, I ask them to bring in a guitar that they feel comfortable with. Or I have guitars in my shop and I'm like, hey, hold this one. Hey, play this one. What do you like about this one? Show me how you hold your hand. And then when I actually shape a guitar neck, I like my client to sit in the shop while I shape it. So I'm taking a rasp. I'm literally shaving the wood off. Okay, I hand it back. We go back and forth maybe a dozen times. I constantly invest in myself and in my shop. There's none of this, hey, let's try to make this work or maybe I can get this to do that. If there's a tool and it does it better, I go find it. A lot of the tools that I have are luthier specific. I like to use diamond files. I like to work to the accuracy of my instruments. If my tool measures to a thousandth of an inch, then my goal is to work to a thousandth of an inch. I learned to work with my hands as a boy. My father has a commercial construction company. So there was months that I was driving tractors or cranes. There's days where pouring concrete or building cabinets or trailers or, you know, I grew up doing it all. When I'm working on an instrument, I have a figure it out attitude. I look at a problem and I try to reverse engineer what's there. Like I see the issue and I try to go backwards to what caused it. When people come in, sometimes we just sit and re-brainstorm. Hey man, what about this capacitor value? Okay, are you gonna be playing this guitar on stage? Is this a guitar you're gonna be recording with? Because those are different things. If a person's going to be recording, then the emphasis is going to be on keeping that guitar as quiet as possible. So we're going to focus on shielding. We're going to have shielded wire. You know, let's take care of the control cavities. I think people come to my shop at first because maybe the Google reviews or word of mouth, or maybe they just stumble upon me. I think what earns me a client for life is the attention to detail, but not only that, is it's an inviting space. It's an actual repair shop. You're gonna come in here, there's gonna be shavings on the floor, there's instruments hanging on the wall, there's instruments all over the place in various states of disrepair. But really, I think clients come because they enjoy just hanging out, talking, having a cup of coffee, and just really talking shop.